Hi, I'm Donna Risto, financial advisor with Edward Jones. The European debt crisis, unemployment, and speculation about recession have all been in the headlines recently. Navigating in the current market volatility can be a challenge. If you're wondering what lies ahead, I'd like to meet with you. Let's work together to make sure you're ready for the ups and downs of the market. Donna Risto, financial advisor, 855-1726, 855-1726. Edward Jones, making sense of investing, member SIPC.
It's a combination of shock and sadness for Arizona as people across the state mourn the loss of 19 elite firefighters. More than 1,000 people turned out at a memorial in Prescott.
Pray mightily when you go home for these families because they're going to need it.
They sacrifice their life for us every day. They never know when they'll get the call.
President Obama called Arizona's governor to express his sorrow and reflected on the loss during his trip to Africa.
This is one more reminder of the fact that our first responders, they put their lives on the line every single day.
First responders saluted a convoy as it brought the bodies of the 19 firefighters home to Prescott on Monday. The firefighters, all members of the Granite Mountain Hotshots, died when a wildfire changed direction and trapped them near the central Arizona town of Yarnell. The deaths marked the nation's biggest loss of firefighters in a wildfire in 80 years. More than half of the dead firefighters were in their 20s, something Prescott's fire chief discussed.
It's a younger man's game. Once again, these people keep themselves in exceptional condition. They have considerable weight to carry, and they can walk miles to get into strategic locations. Oftentimes, they'll sleep on the ground.
200 more firefighters joined the battle against the Yarnell fire, which has spread to 13 square miles and destroyed dozens of homes. Some of them are elite wildfire specialists like the Granite Mountain crew. Firefighters also attended Monday's memorial in Prescott, giving residents a chance to say thank you. Ed Donahue, The Associated Press.